Welcome to Geotopia for you, your one-stop destination for all things geography. In this video, we are going to discuss about scales. But to understand what is a scale, what are its functions, and how many types of scale are out there, we will first need to understand what is a map. A map is a diagrammatic representation of an area of land or sea showing physical features, cities, roads, etc. You can see the map of India and the map of the world on the left and right side of your screen respectively. The size of a map is almost always way smaller than the actual ground area. While preparing maps, we therefore need to decide how much ground distance will be represented by map distance. So, we establish a relationship between map distance and ground distance. This is what we call map scale. A scale can be defined as the ratio between the distance between two places on the map to the actual distance between the same two places on the ground. Scales are unitless because they are a ratio. But why do we need scales? We can correctly represent the Earth or a part of it on a map of required size with the help of scale. Scales help us understand distances correctly. Any map without a proper scale is just a rough sketch. Now we will have a look at the various types of scales. There are three types of map scales. Number 1, statement scale. Number 2, linear scale, also called graphical scale. And number 3 is representative fraction, also known as numeric fraction. Let's now have a look at each of them in details. Number 1, statement scale. In this method, we express the scale in words or make a statement about it. An example of the scale is 1 centimeter to 1 kilometer. This means that 1 centimeter on map represents a distance of 1 kilometer on ground. Advantages of statement scale. This method is very simple. It takes little time to express the scale. It gives correct idea about distances. Disadvantages of statement scale. It can be understood only by those people who are familiar with the unit of measurement used in the scale. When the map is enlarged or reduced, the scale does not remain the same. Number 2. Linear scale, also known as graphical scale. In this method, a straight line is drawn whose length is in proportion to the actual length on the ground. It is divided into primary and secondary divisions so that distances can be easily read from them. Here is an example of graphical scale, also called linear scale. The primary and secondary divisions are marked by the orange and blue lines respectively. Advantages of linear scale. Distances can be easily measured with linear scale. When a map is enlarged or reduced, the linear scale also gets enlarged or reduced in the same ratio and hence remains true to the map. Disadvantages of linear scale. It takes time and proficiency to construct a graphical scale. It can be understood only by those people who are familiar with the unit of measurement used in the scale. Number 3. Representative fraction, also known as numeric fraction. In this method, the ratio existing between the length on the map and the actual length on ground is indicated by a fraction whose numerator is always 1. Now, we look at an example of a representative fraction. The question is, find the representative fraction when statement of scale for a map is 1 centimeter to 1 kilometer. The answer is 1 centimeter on map represents 1 kilometer on ground, or 1 centimeter on map represents 1 lakh centimeters on ground. This is because 1 kilometer is equals to 1 lakh centimeters. Now we know representative fraction is equals to map distance divided by ground distance, which is equal to 1 centimeter divided by 1 lakh centimeter, that is 1 is to 1 lakh. Therefore, the RF is 1 is to 1 lakh. Advantages of representative fraction. Representative fraction is only a fraction and it is independent of any particular unit of measurement. Thus, RF can be used with any unit, and it is for this characteristic that representative fraction is also called international scale or natural scale. Disadvantages of representative fraction. It is only a fraction with no units used. Hence, distances cannot be directly measured from it. It is not easily understood by a common man. When the map is enlarged or reduced, the scale does not remain the same. Here is the index portion of a map. Where you can see all three types of scales being depicted. Hope you found this video informative. Tell us in the comment section what topic you want us to make a video about next. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the content, then please like our videos, share them, and subscribe to our channel.